Okay, so here today we are discussing the damper oscillations. In case of any body like loaded spring, when you pull the bob aside or when you pull the bob downwards through certain distance, say A or A naught, when you pull the bob through certain distance A naught, and when you release them, then it makes up and down oscillations with amplitude A naught. While making oscillations, suppose if no other than restoring forces due to spring, if no other forces acts on the bob to oppose the motion of the bob other than conservative forces, because gravity is there, no? Gravity also acts, that is the conservative force. But here, whenever the bob is under equilibrium position at this point, the gravitational force balances the spring force. That's why net force acts on the bob, acts on this block at this position is zero. From that position, when you displace the bob through certain distance A naught, and when you release them, then it sustains up and down oscillations. These oscillations are because of restoring force developed in the spring, which acts on the block when it is displaced through certain distance A naught. Due to those forces only it makes oscillations. No other forces acts on the block. Okay. So whenever the block is displaced at distance A naught, and when you release them, it makes sustains oscillations up and down with amplitude A naught. If no air resistance is there, suppose if air resistance is there, while it is making oscillations like this, while it is coming down, then the air, the friction due to air acts on the block opposite to the motion. While it is moving up, the friction due to air acts on the block opposite to the motion in downwards direction. So always the friction due to air or air resistance acts on the block opposite to the motion. Because of that, while moving the block in the air or against the air friction or air resistance, some work is to be done by the block to move in forward direction, to move downwards, or to move upwards. So a part of their energy is consumed by the block and to move in the air against the air resistance or friction due to air. Due to that, some energy is lost for each and every oscillation as it's moving in air against the air friction. As the block does some work continuously while making oscillations, it loses a part of their energy. That's why the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases and finally comes to rest. Such type of oscillations made by the body are called the damped oscillations. Okay, and such type of oscillations made by the body, such body which makes damped oscillations are called damped harmonic oscillator. Okay, so the oscillations made by the body with decreasing amplitude due to the presence of some damping forces or due to the presence of some resisting forces are called damped oscillators. That is the definition of the damped oscillations. The oscillations made by the body with decreasing amplitude due to the damping forces or due to the frictional forces acts on the oscillating body are called damped oscillations. That is the definition of the damped oscillations. So the oscillations made by the body, oscillations made by the body means maybe the block or maybe the bob of the pendulum, whatever it may be. The oscillations made by the body with decreasing amplitude due to resistive forces or air resistance or friction, whatever the type of force, due to resistive force, which is called damping force. Due to resistive force or damping force, the oscillations made by the body with a decreasing amplitude due to resistive forces are called damped oscillations. Now, in case of damped oscillations, what are the here while making the damped oscillations, what are the forces acts on the body? Here you see, whenever the block comes down, suppose at certain instant, from the mean position or equilibrium position, suppose the block displaces through a distance, say x. At that time, what are the forces acts on the block? Here, as the spring is extended from this position through a distance x, then spring force acts in upward direction, that is Ax, And at the same time, as the block is moving in this direction, the damping forces acts on the block in upward direction. So damping forces means force due to air resistance. Force due to air resistance, we can write. Okay, damping forces Fd, you write Fd. Fd is the damping force. This damping force acts on the block opposite to the motion. The velocity at that instant, whenever the block is here, suppose the velocity of the block is say v. At that time, the damping force acts on the block. Fd is equal to damping force or resistance force. Damping force comma Fd is equal to some constant b into velocity v, because damping force is directly proportional to velocity. Whenever the velocity is more, damping force is also more. That's why damping force is proportional to velocity. Our damping force is equal to some proportionality constant b into velocity, where proportionality constant b is called damping coefficient. Damping coefficient. Okay, therefore, net force acts on the block whenever net force acts on the body making oscillations when it displaces through a distance x is net force. Net force acts on the block is equal to this net force is opposite to the displacement. That's why we have to net force is the opposing force. No, whenever the displacement is in this direction, the net force acts on the block in opposite direction. That's why net force is equal to minus of kx plus f into fd, kx plus f into d. Okay, here net force according to Newton's second law of motion, net force acts on the block is equal to mass into acceleration, which is equal to minus of kx plus damping force means b into v. Damping force is equal to b into v. Therefore, from this ma plus bv plus kx is equal to zero. M into, how we can write a? We know v is equal to, since velocity v is equal to dx by dt, because displacement of the block is x now. That's why dx by dt is the velocity. Okay, next, acceleration a is equal to. Acceleration A is equal to dv by dt. Dv by dt means d by dt of v means dx by dt. Then we can have d square x by dt square. No, ikkada v plus lo mano dx by dt rasa ankonde d by dt of v ante dx by dt. Appo d of dx by dt into dt. D of dx ante d square x by dt into dt dt square. Okay, so d square x by dt square. So acceleration can be written in terms of displacement as d square x by dt square. So m into a means d square x by dt square, we can write, plus b into v means dx by dt plus k into x is equal to zero. This is equation one. Of course, you write this is one, this is two. Okay, this is the equation of the particle which makes damped oscillations. Equation of the block or particle which makes damped oscillations, where b is the damping coefficient. Where b is the damping coefficient. The solution for this, and ikkada d square x by dt square plus you multiply with m, divide with m, b by m into dx by dt plus k by m, because we are dividing with m, into x is equal to zero. This is equation three. Of course, the solution of this equation and x is equal to something and write, so solution of this equation and x value anta. దీన్ని మనం ఇంటిగ్రేట్ చేసుకుని అట్లా ఎక్స్ వాల్యూ కనుక్కోవాలండి. డెరివేషన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఇన్ అవర్ సిలబస్. ద సొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ కెన్ బి రిటన్ యాస్ డైరెక్ట్లీ. ద సొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ కెన్ బి రిటన్ యాస్ సొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్. కెన్ బి రిటన్ యాస్ ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు సొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ కెన్ బి రిటన్ యాస్ ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ ఇంటూ e to the power of minus bt by 2m into cos omega t plus phi or sin omega t plus phi. Anyone can write cos omega t plus phi. This is the equation. It is the solution for this differential. This is called second order differential equation. And you can get dx by dt and ikkada square undi. Ikkada emo single function undi. ఓన్లీ పవర్ వన్ ఏ. కాబట్టి దీన్ని సెకండ్ ఆర్డర్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ ఈక్వేషన్ అంటాం. మీకు మ్యాథమెటిక్స్ లో నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్ ఎప్పుడు వస్తుందండి. సెకండ్ ఆర్డర్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ ఈక్వేషన్ యొక్క సొల్యూషన్ ఏంటంటే, జస్ట్ యూ హ్యాడ్ రిమెంబర్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా ఓన్లీ, యూ నీడ్ నాట్ రిమెంబర్ దిస్ వన్. జస్ట్ సొల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ది సెకండ్ ఆర్డర్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ డాంప్డ్ ఆసిలేషన్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ power of minus bt by 2m cos omega t plus phi. Okay, actually harmonic function amplitude avalga, so this is the amplitude. Therefore, amplitude of the damped oscillator, amplitude of damped oscillator or damped oscillations, comma, adi a naught anukunte, a naught is equal to coefficient of harmonic function t idi a into exponential to cos bt by 2m. This is the amplitude of the damped oscillations. It is very very important formula. Based on this formula, they ask the problem. So amplitude of damped oscillations is equal to amplitude of the damped oscillations is equal to a into e to the power of minus bt by 2m. Okay, where m is the mass of the particle, and at any time t, the amplitude of oscillating amplitude of the particle makes damped oscillations is a e to the power of minus bt by 2m. Okay, now here from this equation, it is clear that the amplitude of oscillations decreases in a exponential fashion, because amplitude, resultant amplitude of the damped oscillations after any time t, initially the amplitude is a naught. Initially, from this equilibrium position, the body is displaced to a distance a naught, and when it is released, if a resistance is not there, if any damping forces is not, force are not there, then it makes oscillations with amplitude a naught only. That means it is the initial amplitude at t is equal to zero. You see, when t is equal to zero, you will get e to the power of something, e to the power of 0, 1. That's why you will get a only. A is equal to a naught only. A is equal, okay, you write here, this is a naught, this is a. This is a naught. So here in this formula, you write this is a naught. Okay, because at t is equal to 0, amplitude of the particle which makes damped oscillations is equal to, if t 0 raste, e to the power of 0, 1, kaabatti a naught ega, and a naught ega initial. But as long as it makes oscillations, as long as it makes oscillations, time increase up to e to the power of minus something function decrease open. As it decreases up to amplitude decrease open. Kaapate, exponential function the kaapate, the amplitude decreases in a exponential fashion. The amplitude decreases in a exponential fashion. Okay. Shall I erase this one? Now, suppose if you draw the graph by taking amplitude of oscillation along y-axis and time along x-axis. At t is equal to 0, this e to the power of 0, 1, so that is maximum. So a is equal to a naught. Then at t is equal to 0, amplitude of oscillation is maximum. At t is equal to infinity, t infinity raste, e to the power of minus infinity, and 1 by e to the power of infinity. E to the power of infinity is equal to infinity. 1 by e to the power of infinity ante 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity is 0. That's why a is equal to 0. So at t is equal to infinity only, amplitude becomes 0. And at t is equal to infinity ante, it is very large distance. That's why almost all you will get the exponential function like this. Almost all it is parallel to time axis. Parallel to time axis. Indicate, because this curve meets the time axis at infinity only. That's why it draws a parallel line to the time axis. So in this way, the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases with the time. Okay, now mean lifetime. What about the mean lifetime? In this A, mean lifetime. Amplitude, it is a, this is the amplitude of the oscillator A. Next B, mean lifetime. Here already we have written, you see. The solution for the second order differential equation is this one. This is very, very important formula. Okay. Now, generally, the coefficient of harmonic function is the amplitude. No? So, it is the equation of the particle exhibiting damped oscillations. So, it is called equation of particle, equation of particle, or equation of the damped oscillations. Equation of the particle execute damped oscillations. Execute damped oscillations. Execute damped oscillations. Okay, therefore, from this formula, A, amplitude. Amplitude of damped oscillations. Amplitude of damped oscillations. A is equal to the coefficient of harmonic function is the amplitude. That's why amplitude of damped oscillations is this one. So A naught into e to the power of minus bt by time m, bt by 2m. So bt by 2m. Where when time increases, this exponential value decreases so that amplitude decreases, and when time t is equal to infinity, A becomes zero. That means the damped oscillations, the amplitude of the damped oscillations gradually decreases with the time. According to the graph, this one. So you draw the graph here. Draw this graph here. So the amplitude of oscillations of a damped harmonic oscillator varies with the time exponentially. A you take along y-axis and t along x-axis. Okay, then the amplitude of oscillation varies exponentially with the time. So that can be represented like this. Already I said, no? So here at t is equal to 0, as this becomes 1, a is equal to a naught. That is the maximum value. As long as time lapses, this value gradually decreases and it becomes zero only at infinity. That's why A becomes zero only at infinity. That's why exponential curve is almost all after some time. This is parallel to the time axis that represents both meet at infinity. That's why amplitude becomes zero only at infinity. It is the exponential curve. Exponential curve. So what is the nature of the amplitude versus time graph of a particle executing damped oscillations means exponential curve. Okay. Next. So this formula is very, very important. Here we have to remember this formula also. X is equal to, we have a naught e to the power of minus bt by 2m into cos omega t plus phi. Okay. In this formula, B is called a damping coefficient, B by 2m. That is called damping constant. Damping constant is gamma. Gamma is damping constant. Gamma is equal to B by 2m. Damping constant gamma is equal to B by 2m. B is the damping coefficient. Okay. Now I will erase this one. Shall I erase this right side part? Satish sir, okay sir, Satish sir, I have given post to you, co-host to you. Okay, right. So here damping constant gamma is equal to B by 2m. B is called damping coefficient. B is the damping coefficient. Okay. Now shall I erase this part? Shall I erase that part? Okay, next step, in this only. In this formula, x is equal to a naught e to the power of minus bt by 2m cos omega t plus phi. Okay, in that formula, omega is the angular frequency of the damped oscillations. In this formula, omega is called, where omega, angular frequency angular frequency of damped oscillations. Angular frequency of the damped oscillations. Okay, omega naught is the angular frequency of the oscillations. Omega naught is angular frequency of oscillations without damping forces. Whenever damping forces are not there, what is the formula for angular frequency? Tell me. Whenever angular frequency damping forces are not there, then what is the formula for angular frequency? Tell me. Suppose example loaded spring is there. In case of loaded spring, when no damping forces are there, continuously it makes oscillations like this only for any length of time. In such case, what is the formula for angular frequency? In terms of mass, you take. In terms of mass of the block, you say. In terms of mass of the block and spring constant K, you say. Tell me. Root K by M. Yes, very good. Root K by M, M by K. Root K by M, no? So, here this omega naught is equal to root K by M. When damping forces are not there, then the body makes natural oscillations. So in such case, natural oscillations, the frequency is angular frequency is omega naught. That is equal to root K by M. So that is the angular frequency. Okay, now the net angular frequency. The net angular frequency, that means whenever the damping oscillations are there, then net angular frequency is equal to, we are having direct formula only, omega is equal to square root of omega naught square minus gamma, omega naught square minus gamma square. Omega naught square means we can write root k by m whole square. Root k by m whole square and k by m. Minus gamma means damping coefficient. Gamma means damping coefficient. The damping constant is there now. B by 2m whole square. It is very, very important formula. It is also. Its angular frequency is called natural angular frequency also. Natural angular frequency. And it is angular frequency of the damped oscillations. Angular frequency of the damped oscillations. So whenever the damping forces are there, then angular frequency of the damped oscillations changes, which is equal to square root of K by M into B by 2M. Suppose if damping forces are not there, then damping coefficient is zero. When damping coefficient is zero, this term becomes zero. So the angular frequency becomes root K by M. Whenever damping forces are not there, then angular frequency is equal to root K by M only, no? Omega naught is equal to root K by M. That's why it is equal to omega naught. Okay, it is equal to omega naught square. That's why this is the general formula where gamma is the damping constant, which is equal to B by 2M. Okay? So this formula is also important one. Now, in this case, so this is second one, is B. In this case, for over damping. Okay, here you will get three types of graphs based on the this gamma value. Based on this gamma value, or based on the relation between omega naught and gamma, we will have three types of damping. Okay, so here over damping. In this first one, over damping. In case of over damping, damping constant gamma is greater than omega naught. Damping constant gamma is greater than omega naught. Second one, damping constant greater than omega naught means gamma is B by 2M. Greater than omega naught means root K by M. Okay. Next, for critical damping. gamma is equal to omega naught. Third one, for under damping, gamma less than omega naught for under damping. Gamma by far less than omega naught. That is called under damping. Okay. So now in this case, you see, if you draw the graphs, you take the amplitude of oscillation along amplitude of oscillation is this only, no? Amplitude of oscillation A is equal to A naught e to power of minus BT by 2m. Okay. So amplitude along y axis and time along x axis. Okay, in case of overdamping, very fastly the amplitude of oscillation becomes zero in case of overdamping. So this is for overdamping. That means gamma greater than omega naught. When damping constant is greater than omega naught, in such case the amplitude of oscillation gamma is equal to damping constant greater than damping constant. Whenever it is greater, the energy loss is very quickly, and so that the energy becomes zero immediately. So amplitude of oscillation decreases to zero immediately. That type of damping is called overdamping. So okay, in the case for overdamping, this is for overdamping. Okay. Next, whenever in case of underdamping, in case of critical damping, whenever gamma is equal to omega naught, then you will get the graph like this. So this is gamma is equal to omega naught. That means it is critical damping. For under damping, as long as the number of oscillations makes amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases as time increases. You see, initially amplitude of oscillation is this one, that is equal to A naught. When time lapses, amplitude falls. That's why when time lapses, amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases. That is the type of the underdamping. Underdamping means relation gamma by far less than omega naught. In this way, these conditions are very, very important. For overdamping, gamma greater than omega naught. Gamma means B by 2m. B by 2m greater than omega naught, or B greater than 2m into omega naught, we can write. Similarly, for critical damping, gamma is equal to omega naught. Underdamping, gamma by far less than omega naught. In this way, we have to write. Next. See, mean lifetime. This mean lifetime is represented with mean life. How mean? Mean life or how average? No, how average. Mean life means whenever the body makes damped oscillations, as long as time increases, the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases. After some time, the amplitude of oscillation decreases to 1 by E times the initial amplitude. That means A naught by E. After some time, tau average, mean lifetime, tau average. After some time, the amplitude of oscillation becomes 1 by 8 of maximum amplitude. Okay, such time after which the amplitude of oscillation becomes 1 by E times the initial amplitude. Such time is called the mean lifetime. So therefore, the mean life is the time taken by the damped oscillator for its amplitude decay to 1 by E of the initial value. Time taken by particle making damped oscillations, making damped oscillations, time taken by the particle making damped oscillations to decay its amplitude, its initial amplitude. Initial amplitude means A naught. So 1 by E times A naught, that means E naught by A, is called mean lifetime or average lifetime. Mean lifetime. Okay, already we know from this formula, we know from A is equal to A naught e to the power of minus BT by 2M. From this formula, after such time, after mean lifetime, amplitude becomes 1 by E times, 1 by E times A naught. That means that implies A means you write A naught by E is equal to A naught into e to the power of minus B into. As the amplitude becomes 1 by E times some initial amplitude, the time is called mean life or average time. That's why average time, tau average by 2M. Okay, A naught cancel. So E is equal to, here we can write e to the power of B tau average by 2M, no? Implies here e power 1, here e power is this one. As base are equal, powers are equal. That's why B tau average by 2M is equal to 1. Implies tau average is equal to 2M by B. Tau average is equal to 2M by B. That means 2M by B means 1 by gamma, no? It is equal to 1 by gamma. That means reciprocal of damping constant is equal to, numerically equal to, the mean lifetime of the damped oscillator. Mean lifetime is the time taken by the damped oscillator to decrease their amplitude to 1 by e times the initial amplitude. That is called the mean lifetime of the damped oscillator. Okay, so that is one more point. Next, energy of damped oscillator. Next D, energy of the damped oscillator. Energy of damped oscillator. Energy of the damped oscillator at any instant of time. Okay, so energy of the damped oscillator is equal to, generally, the total energy of the damped oscillator, total energy of damped oscillator is equal to general formula half m into omega squared a squared. General formula is this one. Already we know, in case of a particle executing single harmonic oscillations, what is the formula for total energy of the particle? Total energy of the particle is equal to half m omega squared a squared. No? Of course, that is equal to formula for maximum kinetic energy also. Okay, or maximum potential energy, which is equal to half m omega squared into half m omega squared into A means A is equal to, in case of damped oscillator, A is equal to A naught into something. That's why you write A naught into e to the power of minus BT by 2M whole square. BT by 2M whole square. Okay, therefore, from this formula, total energy is equal to, if this m omega square is constant, we can write A. Therefore, total energy is equal to half m omega square into A naught square e to the power of minus BT by M, because e to the power of minus 2 BT by 2M, 2 to cancel BT by M. So this is the formula for total energy of the particle in a section, in total energy of the particle when makes damped harmonic oscillations. Okay, so here maximum energy, E max. Maximum energy means at the beginning, at t is equal to 0, it is having maximum energy, that is equal to half m omega square into a naught square only. When you put t is equal to 0, E value becomes maximum. Then energy becomes maximum. That is equal to half m omega square into a naught square only. So at initial only, it is having maximum energy. Okay. Here in this formula, this can also be written as half k a naught square, where k is equal to m omega square. It is called force constant. A is equal to m omega square, it is called force constant. So for this, if you draw the graph between energy and time,
సార్ వాయిస్ వినపట్టలేదు.
Okay, now are you audible? Am I audible to you? Okay. So here, definitely is my audio is not visible, audible to you or long back? That's now only. Nanda Kishore. From graph onwards, it is not audible. Okay. Here. Energy of the damped oscillator E is equal to half m omega square A naught square e to the power of minus b t by m. Here this is constant. So here energy of the damped oscillator also decreases with time according to the graph like this. Because it is exponential function now, when t is equal to infinity, this becomes zero. At t is equal to zero, this becomes maximum. But as exponential function is there, the energy of the damped oscillator varies with time in exponential fashion only. At t is equal to zero, energy is maximum. Maximum means you put t is equal to zero, then you will get this one. This is the maximum energy. As long as time lapses, energy of the damped oscillator decreases. Already I said why it decreases. Whenever the damped oscillator makes oscillations, while making oscillations, always it has to do work against the air resistance or damping forces. Due to them, some energy. A part of energy is consumed to overcome the friction or overcome the damping forces. That's why. The energy of the damped oscillator gradually decreases and becomes zero only at t is equal to infinity. That's why you will get the energy versus time graph almost all at this end. It is parallel to time axis. That indicates they meet at infinity. At t is equal to infinity only, energy of the damped oscillator becomes zero, theoretically. Okay. Next, relaxation time is here as the energy of the damped oscillator gradually decreases. After some time, the energy becomes 1 by E times the maximum energy. 1 by E times the maximum energy. Such time is called the relaxation time. Such time is called relaxation time. The time in which the energy of the damped oscillator decreases to or decay to 1 by E times the maximum energy is called the relaxation time. So in this formula, you put energy is 1 by E times the maximum energy. Maximum energy means this is the maximum energy. 1 by E times. Means 1 by E into maximum energy means half m omega square A naught square. 1 by E times the maximum energy is equal to, instead of this one I substituted here, then remaining right, half m omega square A naught square equal to minus B by m into whatever T. As I have substituted the energy of the particle in energy of the damped oscillator as 1 by E times the maximum energy, such time taken is equal to relaxation time. That's why you write tau r. Okay, then these two cancel. So 1 by E is equal to. Sir, Satish sir, మీరు కంట్రోల్ చేస్తా ఉన్నారు సౌండ్ నాయిస్ ని. ఏ సార్ నాయిస్ వస్తుంది ఇప్పుడే. ముందు లేదు అసలు. So 1 by E is equal to e to power of minus something means this is equal to 1 by e to power of minus b by m into tau r. As bases are equal, powers are also equal. So 1 is equal to B tau R by M. That implies relaxation time. Tau R is equal to M by B. Tau R is equal to M by B. Which is equal to, already we know, damping constant gamma is equal to B by 2M now. Damping constant gamma is equal to B by 2M. So from that B by 2M is equal to, how we can write? 2 gamma. B by 2M is equal to 2 gamma. M by B means 1 by 2 gamma. 1 by 2 gamma is the relaxation time. 1 by 2 gamma is the relaxation time. Okay. This is also important relation. Okay, next. Relaxation time is over. Next, power dissipation. Last point in this. Power dissipation. hour dissipation. Okay, whenever the energy is lost, the energy lost per second is called power dissipation. Power dissipation or power consumed. Power capital P. So power dissipation P is equal to rate of loss of energy. Suppose in dt seconds, when the damped oscillator makes oscillations in a time dt seconds, it loses energy dE as it is the loss of energy put to minus sign. Then the energy lost per second, that means dE by dt, that is called the power dissipation. Power dissipation means minus, right? Okay, this is equal to minus dE by dt of what is the energy of the damped oscillator? This one now. So half m omega square a naught square into e to the power of minus b t by m. Okay, this is equal to when you differentiate them, then minus half, these all are constant except the function e. m omega square a naught square into d by dt of exponential to the power of minus b t by m. Okay, therefore minus half m omega square a naught square into what is the differentiation of exponential function? First, we had to write exponential function as it is minus b, e to the power of minus bta by m into. Then you had to differentiate this power d by dt of minus bt by m. Minus b by m is constant. You write aside minus b by m into d by dt of t 1. That's why you have this one. Minus minus plus mm cancel. So therefore, power is equal to here we have omega square a naught square b by 2 into e to the power of minus bt by small.
Sir, voice breaking, sir.
Hello?
Voice breaking.
సార్ నాకు ఇంతకుముందు అసలు ప్రాబ్లం ఎప్పుడు లేదు సార్, మరి మీ కోస్ట్ గా జాయిన్ అయిన తర్వాత ప్రాబ్లం వస్తుంది.
హలో సార్,
ఎట్లా అన్మ్యూట్ చేసుకుంటున్నారమ్మా అసలు?
హలో సార్, హలో సార్,
హలో సార్,
అన్మ్యూట్
మ్యూట్
అన్మ్యూట్ గాన్రా.
ఓకే, నౌ ఆర్ యు హియరింగ్ మై వాయిస్? ఆర్ యు హియరింగ్ మై వాయిస్? ఓకే, సో పవర్ డిసిపేషన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు P ఈక్వల్ టు దిస్ వన్. So we have P is equal to omega square a naught square b by 2 into e to the power of minus bt by m. Okay, now what about omega? You see, omega square a naught square e to the power of minus bt by m, that can be written as 2e by m. No, 2e by m omega square a naught square by omega square a naught square by 2 into e to the power of minus btm can be written as e by m. You write e by m. This can be written as e by m. Here e is the energy at the given instant of time. Okay, into b is there, you write b, because omega square a naught square by 2 into e to the power of minus bta by m can be written as e. So instead of omega square a naught square by 2 into e to the power of minus btm, e as E we have written. Okay, E by M. Okay, E by M. So E by M I have written. E to B is there, B I have written. So therefore, power dissipation is equal to E B by M. Power dissipation is equal to E B by M. You write in terms of gamma. We know damping constant gamma is equal to, what is the formula for damping constant? Damping constant gamma is equal to B by 2 into M. No, instead of B by M, we can write 2 gamma. That's why this is equal to E into 2 gamma. Therefore, power dissipation is equal to 2E gamma. This is the power dissipation. R P is equal to 2E into gamma means B by 2M. So 2, 2 you cancel. So P is equal to we can write BE by M also. This is the power distribution, where E, energy at any instant, energy. Power dissipation at some instant of time, they ask it. Then at that instant, what is the energy you write? Energy at a given instant of time. Energy at a given instant of time. So this is about the damped oscillations. This is about damped oscillations. Okay. Last point. Last point in this topic. Last point in this topic. Yeah. Quality factor. Quality factor, that is represented with capital Q. Quality factor is represented with capital Q. So that quality factor is equal to quality factor is equal to 2 pi into total energy of the damped oscillator by energy lost during one time period. Total energy of the damped oscillator by energy lost during one time period. Initial energy of the damped oscillator, initial energy by, initial energy means, here you see, energy is equal to this one now, initial energy means at T is equal to 0, that is the maximum energy, that's why maximum energy, initial energy means Emax, by energy lost during one time period. This is called the quality factor of the damped oscillator. Okay, this is about damped oscillator. Next, because of damped oscillator, the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases. And finally, after an infinite time theoretically, the amplitude of oscillation becomes zero. Such type of oscillations are called the damped oscillator. Okay, damped oscillations. So in case of damped oscillations, as long as the time increases, the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases. But in order to maintain the oscillations without a decreasing amplitude, what we have to do? Anybody else respond? Damped oscillations vanna amplitude of oscillation gradually decrease aipothundi. Adi decrease kaagoddu. Decrease kaakanna undalante manam em cheyali? Decrease kaakanna undalante manam em cheyali? External force is to be applied. External force is to be applied on the particle. So that when you nullify the damped oscillations, then the particle oscillates with the same amplitude. Such type of oscillations are called the forced oscillations. Aithe ikkada external force ni continuous ga okay direction apply cheyala frequent ga vary avutu undala. Suppose you see, okay, shall I arrange this total both? Yeah, you have to vary. I will explain. Shall I arrange this one? Just ఈ ఫోర్స్ ఆసిలేషన్స్ ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనకి ఫండమెంటల్స్ ఉన్నాయండి ఫార్ములాస్ ఉన్నాయి poster operations. Suppose here, you see one particle makes damped oscillations. As long as it makes oscillations, the amplitude of oscillation gradually decreases and finally comes to rest. Am I right? Suppose when the particle moving in this direction, damped oscillations are in opposite direction. When the particle moving in this direction, the damping force is in opposite direction. Damping force in this direction, when the particle is moving in this direction. Okay, in order to move with the same velocity or constant velocity, in order to move with the same amplitude in this direction, these damped oscillations must be nullified. Ante in opposite direction mana external force apply cheyali. Some external force is to be applied on the particle in this direction to make the oscillations without decreasing amplitude. While coming in this direction, okavela whenever the particle comes in this direction, then damping force acts in opposite direction. Damping force acts in this direction. Because of that, the amplitude of oscillation decreases and energy is lost. But in order to maintain the same oscillations, if you apply the external force in this direction, then the particle sustains oscillations. The particle can sustain their oscillations. Similarly, whenever the particle moves in this direction, damping forces are in opposite direction, in this direction. It moves in a proper damping force opposite direction. You have to apply the external periodic force on the particle in this direction. While moving in this direction, external periodic force must be applied on the particle in this direction. And along which direction the particle is moving in damped oscillations, along the same direction we have to apply the external periodic force. ఇటువైపు ట్రావెల్ చేసి ఎక్స్టర్నల్ పీరియాడిక్ ఫోర్స్ ఇటువైపు అప్లై చేస్తున్నాం, ఇటువైపు వచ్చినప్పుడు ఈ డైరెక్షన్ అప్లై చేస్తున్నాం. అంటే ద డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫోర్స్ యాక్స్ ఆన్ ది పార్టికల్ వేరియస్ పీరియాడికలీ విత్ టైమ్. డైరెక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ఫోర్స్ అప్లైడ్ ఆన్ ది పార్టికల్ మేకింగ్ ఆసిలేషన్స్ వేరియస్ పీరియాడికలీ. అంటే ఇక్కడ టోటల్ టైం టేకన్ బై ద పార్టికల్ టు కంప్లీట్ వన్ ఆసిలేషన్ క్యాపిటల్ టి అనుకోండి, ఒక టీ బై టూ సెకండ్స్ వరకు ఇటువైపు అప్లై చేయాలి, టీ బై టూ సెకండ్స్ వరకు ఇటువైపు అప్లై చేయాలి. ఇట్ అప్లై ద ఎనీ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ ఏ బాడీ. If we apply any force on a body in regular intervals of time or in a periodic time, such force is called external periodic force. Such force is called external periodic force. So the body vibrates under the influence of the external periodic force such that it vibrates with the frequency r. And if external periodic force apply chesinappudu, the body may vibrates with the frequency equal to natural frequency or frequency of the external periodic force. ఎక్స్టర్నల్ పీరియాడిక్ ఫోర్స్ మనం రెగ్యులర్ ఇంటర్వల్స్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ లో అప్లై చేస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి దానికి కూడా ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, వెన్ యు మేక్ ద పార్టికల్ టు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఆసిలేషన్స్ విత్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఈక్వల్ టు ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఆఫ్ ది ఎక్స్టర్నల్ పీరియాడిక్ ఫోర్స్ ఆర్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఆఫ్ ది నేచురల్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఆఫ్ ది గివెన్ పార్టికల్ ఓన్లీ, సచ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఆసిలేషన్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఆర్ సచ్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ వైబ్రేషన్స్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ద ఫోర్స్ వైబ్రేషన్స్ ఆర్ ఫోర్స్ ఆసిలేషన్స్. ద ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఆఫ్ ది బాడీ frequency of the oscillating body need not be equal to natural frequency of the body only. Natural frequency ante omega naught undi kada, omega naught is the natural frequency. Okay, our natural frequency vibrate also leda man apply chesina external periodic force yokka frequency tho vibrate avutundi kani amplitude constant ga untundi. Such type of oscillations are called forced oscillations. Therefore, if the body vibrates under the influence of the body makes oscillations or vibrations under the influence of external periodic force, under the influence of external periodic force with a natural frequency or frequency of external periodic force. Frequency of external periodic force. If the body makes oscillations under the influence of the external periodic force, with a natural frequency or frequency of the external periodic force, comma, then the oscillations are called forced oscillations or forced vibrations. Forced oscillations are forced vibrations. Bose-Lowenstein oscillations are Bose-Lowenstein vibrations. Okay. Here, the natural whenever the body makes Bose-Lowenstein oscillations, the natural frequency of the body need not be equal to the frequency of the external periodic force. In Bose-Lowenstein oscillations, in Bose-Lowenstein oscillations, the natural frequency of the body, natural frequency of the body need not be equal to the frequency of the external periodic force. Frequency of external periodic force. External periodic force ante man apply chesina force. External periodic force. External periodic force. Okay, now the external periodic force to be applied on the body can be represented as Fe is equal to the applied external force kuda periodic force kaabatti dani kuda in terms of sine function gaani cosine function gaani express cheyachandi. Fe is equal to F naught into sin omega t. F is equal to F naught into sin omega t. So whenever the particle makes damped oscillations, whenever the particle makes damped oscillations, tell me what is the net force on the particle. Man inda formula note chesam equation 1 damped oscillations. So what is that formula? M into d square x by dt square plus what is the formula we got? M into d square x by dt square plus b into dx by dt plus k into x kada manaku vachindi k into x. This must be equal to the external periodic force F naught into sin omega t. This is the second order differential equation for the forced vibrations or forced oscillations. Forced vibrations or forced oscillations. Then the solution for this equation is the solution of this equation. Manaki derivations em levante direct ga formula ne solution of this equation is equal to x is equal to some a into sin omega t minus phi, where phi is the phase difference between the external periodic force and the vibrating particle. A particle ki nu deeniki mancha phase difference andi. Phase difference between the particle and driving force. Driving force ante external periodic force. Ee periodic force ne driving force ani kuda antaru. This is also called as the driving force. It is equation 2 say phi is the phase difference between particle, displacement of the particle x ante ee x undi ga displacement of the particle. At any instant of time, whenever the particle reaches the point here, the displacement is say x. X ki and phi, periodic force, external periodic force, Fe. Ee rendu madhya phase difference is phi ante ikkada. So what is the solution for this? Solution for this equation is this one. Deenlo what is the amplitude? Amplitude A is equal to F naught by M into ఎన్ని కూడా ఫార్ములాస్ ఉన్నాయండి డెరివేషన్స్ ఇంకా హై స్టాండర్డ్స్ లో ఉన్నాయి మీకు హై స్టాండర్డ్స్ అంటే హై స్టాండర్డ్ అదర్ క్లాసెస్ లో ఉంటాయి హైయర్ స్టాండర్డ్స్ సో ఇన్ బ్రాకెట్స్ ఒమేగా నాట్ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ ఒమేగా ఈ స్క్వేర్ హోల్ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ ఒమేగా ఈ స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ గామా బై ఎం గామా అంటే బి బై టూ ఎం కదా గామా బై ఎం స్క్వేర్ the amplitude here is equal to F naught by M into square root of omega naught square minus omega e square whole square plus omega e square of gamma by M whole square. It is the formula for amplitude of the particle. It is the formula for amplitude of the particle when makes forced oscillations. Okay, from this formula, if damping is absent, okavela damping ledu ante, gamma zero ne kada, damping constant zero ne kada. If damping is absent, only external periodic force undi, damping absent ayindi, spring force undi. Appudu in the case when damping is absent or damping force is absent, in this formula, this is the equation 3. This is very, very important formula. It is amplitude. When damping is absent, damping absent is gamma 0. Damping coefficient, damping absent is B0. B0 is gamma 0. Since gamma is equal to B by 2M. Since B is equal to 0, damping absent is B0. Damping coefficient 0. That is 0 is damping constant 0. You put damping constant 0 here. Then amplitude A is equal to F0 by M into. Is it 0 is only term of the omega naught square minus omega e square. Whole square root under the root cancel in gravity. So, F naught by M into omega naught square minus omega e square. That is the amplitude. E B, forced oscillation Sunday. These are my good bit was in the amplitude of the damper, amplitude of the forced oscillations. E B, and for damping lack of the amplitude. F naught by M into omega naught square minus omega e square. EB formulas good bit quality. Because damped oscillations lo chala formulas unnai dantlo especially amplitude and energy ee formulas rendu gurt pettukovali amplitude of the damped oscillator and energy of the damped oscillator these two formulas have to be remembered okay now based on this what are the problems based on this damped oscillations and forced oscillations what are the problems so we have to discuss now okay all of you open your material only just four problems in the 9 day four or five problems in the total. Page number 36 in our material. Page number 36. All of you open your material. Page number 36.